The St. Regis Parish family gathers to celebrate the 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time. There are two announcements. Sunday, August 21st, is the St. Regis Parish picnic at the Monroeville Municipal Park. Bring the whole family and enjoy an open-air mass at noon, followed by food, fun, and friendship from 1 to 4. St. Regis will provide the burgers, hot dogs, chicken, drinks, and more. All are asked to bring a covered dish based on your last name. See the bulletin for details. We do need to know how many will be coming, so please complete the form found in the bulletin and return it in the offertory basket or to the parish office by August 15th. Coffee, donuts, and lemonade is being served after Mass in Gillen Hall, hosted by the Sleeping Bag Ministry. The Sleeping Bag Ministry is comprised of ladies who get together once a week, sew and assemble sleeping bags from donated blankets for homeless people in the area. Please feel free to ask a donut hostess today about the ministry. That's coffee, donuts, and lemonade after Mass today in Gillen Hall.
Please pick up the hymnal and turn to the opening hymn, number 788, City of God, number 788.
Awake from your slumber, arise from your sleep. A new day is dawning for all those who weep. The people in darkness have seen a great light. The Lord of your longing has conquered the night. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into day.
We are sons of the morning, we are daughters of day. The one who has loved us has brightened our way. The Lord of all darkness has called us to be a light for his people, to set their hearts free. Let us build a city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into day.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we gather together to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us prepare ourselves to enter more fully into the celebration of God's love as we call to mind our sins, those times that we have turned away from the Lord's love and grace, and let us ask our merciful God for pardon and peace. You, Lord, will not forget the cries of those who seek you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Your promises, O Christ, are worthy of trust. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come to take us to our heavenly homeland. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The night of the Passover was known beforehand to our fathers, that with sure knowledge of the oaths in which they put their faith, they might have courage. Your people awaited the salvation of the just and the destruction of their foes. For when you punished our adversaries, in this you glorified us you had summoned. For in secret, the holy children of the good were offering sacrifice and putting into effect with one accord the divine institution. The word of the Lord.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Exalt you just in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Blessed the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those whose hope for his kindness. to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us who have put our hope in you.
Blessed are the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, faith is a realization of what is hoped for, an evidence of things not seen. Because of it, ancients were well attested. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to go out to a place that he was to receive as an inheritance. He went out, not knowing where he was to go. By faith, he sojourned in the promised land as in a foreign country, dwelling in tents with Isaac and Jacob, heirs of the same promise. For he was looking forward to the city with foundations, whose architect and maker is God. By faith, he received power to generate, even though he was past the normal age and Sarah herself was sterile. For he thought that the one who made the promise was trustworthy. So it was that there came forth from one man, himself as good as dead, descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky and as countless as the sands on the seashore. All these died in faith. They did not receive what had been promised, but saw it and greeted it from afar and acknowledged themselves to be strangers and aliens on earth. For those who speak thus show that they are seeking a homeland. If they had been thinking of the land from which they had come, they would have had opportunity to return. But now they deserve a better homeland, a heavenly one. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared a city for them. By faith, Abraham, when put to the test, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises was ready to offer his only son, of whom it was said, "Through Isaac, descendants shall bear your name." He reasoned that God was able to raise even from the dead, and he received Isaac back as a symbol. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
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 Hallelujah. Be watchful and ready. You know not when the Son of Man is coming.
Alleluia.
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 The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not be afraid any longer, little flock, for your Father is pleased to give you the kingdom. Sell your belongings and give alms. Provide money bags for yourselves that do not wear out, an inexhaustible treasure in heaven that no thief can reach nor moth destroy. For where your treasure is, there also will your heart be. Gird your loins and light your lamps, and be like servants who await their master's return from a wedding, ready to open immediately when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds vigilant upon his arrival. Amen, I say to you, he will gird himself, have them recline at table, and proceed to wait on them. And should he come in the second or third watch and find them prepared in this way, blessed are those servants. Be sure of this: if the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You must also be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come." Then Peter said, "Lord, is this parable meant for us or for everyone?" And the Lord replied, "Who then is the faithful and prudent steward whom the master will put in charge of his servants to distribute the food allowance at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master on arrival finds doing so. Truly I say to you, the master will put the servant in charge of all his property. But if that servant says to himself, 'My master is delayed in coming,' and begins to beat the men servants and the maid servants, to eat and drink and get drunk, then that servant's master will come on an unexpected day at an unknown hour and will punish the servant severely and assign him a place with the unfaithful. That servant who knew his master's will but did not make preparations nor act in accord with his will shall be beaten severely. But the servant who was ignorant of his master's will but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating shall be beaten only lightly. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much, and still more will be demanded from the person entrusted with more." The Gospel of the Lord. Jesus is saying a lot in the Gospel today. There's a lot in there. But that parable, that little story that's in the middle of the Gospel, is instructive for us. We normally don't hear passages like that at this time of the year. But it reminds us that as people of faith, we must always keep our attention focused on where it needs to be. Sometimes we Christians can get a little bit morbid. We can get a little bit obsessed with death, and passages like this can sometimes frighten us, but that's not the intent. We should not obsess about death. We should not be morbidly thinking about it, but it is a reality that as we live out our days, one day we will come to the last day. And sometimes that can come, as we know, as we're reminded in the parables in the gospel, like a thief in the night. And so the call for us is to be watchful and ready, not living in fear, not obsessed with when that day will come, but living in a state of readiness. And we do that by building up that treasure that lasts. If we are doing the things the gospel calls us to do, then there is nothing more for us to be feared, to fear, or to be concerned about. Are we doing the things that build up that treasure which lasts? And we heard in the gospel last week, you know, it ended, you know, Jesus says, so it will be, and if we're not building up that treasure, being rich in what's important in the eyes of God. That's the treasure that we need to be building up. Taking to heart what the gospel teaches us. Taking to heart what Jesus teaches us is important. To love as he loves. To practice charity. Giving alms, as we hear in the gospel today. Selling what we have and giving alms. Practicing generosity. Showing mercy. Forgiveness, understanding, respect. All of those things that Jesus teaches us. And if we are doing those things, if we are taking to heart the teachings of the gospel and striving to be the best disciples that we can be, the most faithful followers of Jesus as we live out our individual vocations, that's what we need to be doing. And if we are doing that truly and sincerely, that's the treasure that we're building up, then that's where our heart will be, on the things of God. Our heart will be where it needs to be. If we become overly concerned about things of this world, things that may seem important in the moment, but ultimately are not, then that's where our heart goes. And so really the gospel is calling us to reflect in our own lives. As we sit here today, where are our hearts? What is the treasure that we are building? Are we seeking to be rich in that which matters to God? Are we seeking to put into practice all those virtues that the gospel teaches us? Are we seeking to grow in our understanding of what our faith is about? And if we are doing that, great. To the extent that we're not doing that, we have work to do. And that's why we keep coming back, season in and season out, week in and week out, continuing to avail ourselves of God's grace so that we can grow in understanding of that which is truly important, so that we can go forth in our lives every day and put into practice those gospel virtues. Practicing forgiveness and charity and generosity and all the rest. As we come here in our celebration of the Eucharist, let us pray for the grace of understanding, that we can truly take to heart the teachings of the gospel, that to which Christ is calling us. And then as we are fed and nourished here, we can go forth in our lives as we live out our vocations as husbands and wives, as mothers and fathers, as grandmothers and grandfathers, as we go about our life's work, as we go about all that we do each and every day. We are putting into practice that which the gospel teaches us, and that in all things we are being rich in what matters to God. And if we do that, then we have need to be concerned about nothing more, because we are living as we are truly called in Christ and growing in His life. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us be watchful and waiting as we offer our prayers to God.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That the followers of Christ remain vigilant, praying, serving others, and resisting the ways of the world, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. That world leaders may have as a common goal the end of violence and terror against the helpless and against each other, especially in Ukraine, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. That the elderly and infirm, especially those without the support of family members, be treated with dignity, patience, and love. We pray. Lord, hear our prayer. That those young people deciding to spend their lives in a religious vocation have the courage and strength to follow the will of God. We pray. Lord, hear our prayer. That missionaries the world over, especially the Lay Mission Helpers Association, have our support and be in our prayer always. We pray. Lord, hear our prayer. That those who died in faith, especially Mary Kay Wagner and David Paola, may rejoice one day to see all they believed in and hoped for. We pray. Lord, hear our prayer. During this Mass, we remember in a particular way the living and deceased members of the St. Regis Parish family. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold deep in our hearts which we now pause to add.
O Lord, our soul waits for you, you who are our help and shield. Listen to the hearts of your children and hear the prayers, hear our prayers, as we place our trust in you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our presentation hymn is number 822, We Walk by Faith. Number 822.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty in salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. So with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, You give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, Jesus himself took bread, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Regis and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Larry, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
And let us now pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you.
Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 852, Be Not Afraid, number 852.
Shall see the face of God
and live.
Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest.
If you pass through raging waters, in the sea shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side, know that I go before you always.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. As we announced last weekend, this weekend we are having our annual mission cooperation appeal. We have the opportunity different times of the year to contribute to the missionary work of the church financially, and we have that again in the missionary co-op collection. But it's also our one time a year to actually hear what is going on in the missionary fields of the church, that which is happening in our name. It's an opportunity to hear what's going on and to be able to pray for our missionaries as well. This year, our missionary co-op speaker is from the Diocese of Greensburg, but her vocation has taken her far afield to the country of Ghana in West Africa. Karen Hunka from the Lay Missionary Helpers Association is our missionary speaker this year, and so I invite her to come forward and share with us what is happening as she works in the missionary work of the church.
Good afternoon, or evening. I am Karen Hunka, a missionary serving in Ghana, Africa. First, I want to thank the Most Reverend Bishop Larry Kulik, Father Anthony Carbone, your diocesan mission director, and Father George for giving me the opportunity to speak to you today on behalf of Lay Mission Helper Association. Let me tell you a little about myself. As Father had said, I was born and raised in Latrobe, Pennsylvania, and I am a parishioner of St. Florian's Church in United, PA. That's right outside of Mount Pleasant. For years, I desired to be a missionary, but working, raising four children, and caring for elderly parents kept me quite busy. I put my profession as an accountant on hold, and after 40 years living away from Western Pennsylvania, I moved back to take my mother out of a nursing facility and care for her where she wanted and deserved to be, at home. I was blessed to be my mother's caregiver for 3 years. In November of 2017, when my mother passed away, I had a decision to make. I knew with my work experience I was marketable. Going back into the workforce would not be difficult. However, this no longer seemed important to me. I felt there was something else I should be doing. The Holy Spirit was calling me to go down a different path. At the age of 60, I was being called to mission. It was not easy to find an organization willing to send someone my age off to live in a remote and impoverished part of the world. But with resources provided to me by my parish priest at St. Florian's, Father John Sedlak, and with his continuous support and encouragement, I found an organization that seemed to be perfect. I filled out a Lay Mission Helper Association application and flew to Los Angeles, California for a weekend of discernment and interviews. Ultimately, I was accepted into their mission program. Lay Mission Helpers Association is a Catholic organization that provides training and support for lay people who serve 3 years in mission around the world. Lay Mission Helpers knows that going on mission in a distant country is not easy. In August of 2018, I flew again to Los Angeles and for 4 months worked on developing the skills and knowledge I needed to serve successfully. Finally, on January 23rd, 2019, I flew to Ghana, Africa, where I serve as an accountant for the Diocese of Damongo. I live at St. Anne's Girls Boarding Senior High School. My accommodations are obviously different than what we Americans are used to. I live in a bungalow. and I must bucket bathe and wash my clothes by hand. It took me a while, but finally I learned to eat food their way, with my hand. Girls at the school laughed when I told them in America, we eat with forks and spoons. In a typical week, I attend Mass every Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday. On Sundays, as I drive to the church in my air-conditioned truck, I see hundreds of Catholics, young and old, walking for miles in extreme heat to attend Mass. They are so eager to have the mystery of God's love and his words explained to them. Sunday Masses can last up to 2.5 hours and is very lively, with clapping, swaying, drumming, dancing, and singing. Near the end of the Mass, the bishop will welcome the youngsters to the front and question them about the day's readings. I very often find myself in tears, witnessing the knowledge, love, and dedication these young children have for Christ. The Catholic in my villages have nothing, but because they have Christ in their lives, they really have everything they need. Coming back to the United States after living in my little village will not be easy for me. I will leave a life in which I am comfortable. As strange as it might seem to most of you, I will miss hand washing my clothes, bucket bathing, and even eating my favorite Ghanaian foods with my hand. I will miss the look of appreciation on the villagers' faces when I buy my daily vegetables and fruit at their stand at the outdoor market. I try to speak to them in Ganja, the language of the largest tribe in the village. Although sometimes they laugh at me, I know they appreciate my respect for them and their language. The cost for Lay Mission Helpers Association to support a missionary for a 3-year commitment is around $30,000. This includes the training in Los Angeles, airfare to the mission, medical insurance, and a monthly stipend. My 3-year commitment to serve as a missionary ended last December. Fortunately, I was asked to serve one more year. I am home now for a short break, but in 2 weeks I will return to Africa to end my 4th year serving God's people. I have already been asked to serve a 5th year. I have not made up my decision. I have not given my decision yet. The motto of Lay Mission Helpers is, "For we are God's helpers." Please consider helping them as they work to make a difference in people's lives around the world. Any financial contribution you can make will be greatly appreciated. Also, please know that your spiritual support and prayers are invaluable. Thank you again, Father George, for giving me the opportunity to share my story with you and with your parishioners. God bless.
Thank Karen for sharing her thoughts and words with us, and for her dedication to working in Ghana. We have the opportunity to support the Lay Missionary Helpers Association financially with our Mission Co-op Appeal collection this weekend. We'll be forwarding all the contributions to the diocese to help fund their ongoing work and training lay people to continue the fine work that they do. As you know, I was recently in Notre Dame on my program of priestly renewal. One of the priests who was in the program with me is serving in the the Diocese of Des Moines, Iowa, and he's from Ghana. So I heard about those 2- and 3-hour masses, he had to tone it down a little bit for Des Moines, as you might imagine. But yes, it's the wonderful spiritual vitality of the church in Africa is something for us to behold. And just as we contribute, we help one another. We can learn from them as we support them financially in all the different ways that we do. So thank you, Karen, for being with us. Just a reminder, the parish picnic is coming up on August 21st. There was an error in the bulletin last week, a typo on the email address. It is corrected in the bulletin today, so if you want to respond by email, the correct address is in there. I'd also draw your attention in the bulletin today, we are joining with the Trafford Elementary School PTO to do a school supply drive over the next two weekends, next weekend and the weekend after. We'll have collection boxes in the main area and also in the side entrance to the parking lot where you can bring in school supplies to help the students who do not have what they need to start school. There's more information about that in the bulletin today as well. And let us stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, and don't forget the coffee and donuts, too. I forgot that.
Our closing hymn is number 905, Canticle of the Sun, number 905.
Are telling the glory of God, and all creation is shouting for joy. Come dance in the forest, come play in the field, and sing, sing to the glory of the Lord. Praise for the sun, the bringer of day. He carries the light of the Lord in his rays. The moon and the stars who light up the way unto your throne. The heavens are telling the glory of God, and all creation is shouting for joy. Come dance in the forest, come play in the field, and sing, sing to the glory of the Lord. Praise for the wind that blows through the trees, the sea's mighty storms, the gentlest breeze. They blow where they will, they blow where they please, to please the Lord. The heavens are telling the glory of God, and all creation is shouting for joy. Come dance in the forest, come play in the field, and sing, sing to the glory of the Lord. Praise for the rain that waters our fields and blesses our crops, so all the earth yields from death unto life, her mystery revealed unto the Lord. The heavens are telling the glory of God, and all creation is shouting for joy. Come dance in the fields, come play in the fields.